Brother Scotty, I can honestly say that I've had a pretty decent life this far. Born into a Christian home.
Amen.
I have a mom and dad that are Sunday school teachers, a father that's a deacon. Cousins who are just like my brothers to me. Uncles who's always took me hunting, fishing. And we've had trials, Brother Terry, and I understand that. But through it all, God's been good.
Amen.
And as an 8-year-old boy, the greatest thing he ever gave me was salvation.
Amen.
And he's been so sweet ever since then.
Yeah.
He wouldn't have to do a thing for me to stand here tonight and say, God's been good.
Amen.
And I just enjoyed myself tonight with the songs, the testimony that's been going on. And I'm just honest. Let's just let God have his way here tonight. Amen.
Amen.
And I had some things on my heart, and they just kind of been getting switched around, and that's okay with me. I don't care. We just read what God puts on our heart, and we preach where he takes us down, and we let the chips fall where they fall. But I can say this, God's been good. And this little church has blessed me these last few days. And if anything you know that you guys have blessed me. And you can say, well, preacher, how's that? Brother Terry, it blesses my heart when I see someone come up to an altar to pray and the church comes with them. So I can tell you that it does something to me when God's children still believe in the power of prayer.
Amen.
And I just want you to know that as long as he's sitting at the right hand of God making intercession for us, you have access to the Father.
Amen.
And we're going to be reading probably one of the most popular verses or chapters of all this King James here. But we're going to be in Psalms 23. It's just 6 little verses. We're going to read them and we'll go back through them. But I want to say it's good to be saved. Starting with verse 1, most of you probably won't even need the Bible for it. It says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Verse 2 says, he maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Verse 3 says, he restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Amen. Glory.
Verse 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Verse 5 says, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over.
Yes, amen.
Verse 6 says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I can tell you, this is just a simple little verses here, but they pack some power to them tonight, church. And I was telling my wife, driving back home after this morning's service, Kenny, I said, you know, it just seems like I might have been a little hard on them throughout these last couple of days, and I hope there's no hard feelings there. But I can tell you this, I just want to say I'm thankful to be a child of God. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. I can tell you this, that we don't know what a shepherd really is, Jake. We live with farms, with fences, and different things. Animals that are caged up, and they even have robot-like things that bring water out there. Drops feed at a certain time. But when David wrote this, it was different to him. We know David as a king, but he started out a shepherd boy. Amen. He was in a time and place where the shepherd went through the wilderness, Jake. And everything of those sheep, they depended on the shepherd. The shepherd was the one who was in charge of the whole flock. Amen. He had a love for those animals. Amen. I want to say this to you today. God has a love for you. Amen. Whether you're his child or you're a sinner lost and undone, there's a heavenly Father who has love for you. Amen. He says, I shall not want, Terry. I know my needs are going to be met in the Lord. David, the same one who wrote this, he said, I was young, but now I'm old.
Yeah.
But I've never seen the righteous forsaken for his seed begging bread.
Right.
I'm thankful tonight that my shepherd is able to meet my needs. Amen.
Amen.
Right.
He's able to feed me.
Amen.
He's able to give me my water. Amen.
That's right.
Jake, he knows where the danger's at.
Right.
He can lead me around it. Amen.
Right.
It says in verse 2, it says, he making me lie down in green pastures. I'm going to need a sip tonight. It says that he makes me lie down in green pastures. I want you to know there's a lot more going on in that verse than just thinking about laying down in some pasture fields. I can tell you this, sheep are some of the skittiest little animals they are. Sheep need a few things before they can lie down, Jake. Bear with me tonight. I can tell you this, they need all absence of fear to be gone from them. Be where they're comfortable to lay down. We'll get into it tonight. They also need no tension among the flock, amen. Because they'll butt heads and they'll fight for the grazing spots when the shepherd's not around. A sheep can't be aggravated by parasites and the mole flies that are out there. And I can tell you this, if they're hungry, they will not lay down. They will try to find food. I'm thankful today that I have a shepherd that makes me lie down in green pastures tonight. Terry, I can tell you this, the Bible says he hasn't given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and of a sound mind tonight. We are free from fear, amen.
That's right. Amen.
One thing that should be in the flock is the butting of the heads, amen. Those sheep, when the shepherd ain't around, they stand up, they butt heads, and they push one another around. They won't lie down while they're fighting, amen. We can be going to chickens. Amen. Okay, I'm so thankful we can preach about anything. Amen. We can tie it to the Word of God. The chickens, it's called a pecking order. Amen. They'll fight and fight until the one that's the toughest gets to eat first. Amen. But the sheep, they butt heads over what they can eat. Oh, I can tell you this, Rainey. I'm thankful I can lie down in a green pasture. And I'm not in competition, Jake, with you tonight. Kenny, I'm not in competition with you tonight. Oh, there's one shepherd, amen. He's the head of it all. Savior of the body.
Yes,
and anybody's to be glorified tonight. It is him, amen. He's the one that deserves it.
Amen. That's right.
No man deserves to be puffed up tonight. No member deserves to be striving against one another.
Right.
We're in this together, church. We look out and we see different churches here. Thank God they come out to support a revival. Amen. But I can tell you this, Jake, it's just good to get in God's house where you know the Word of God is going to be preached to you and the Spirit and love of God.
Amen.
There's a lot of churches that you go into, and that's not the case.
Right.
Amen, to have a little program.
Amen.
You can open up that pamphlet. I know I hunt on property in Hastings, Jake. Everything's laid out for us.
Right.
We go in there, and it's the only church we go in there. But they got a little pamphlet. You know what songs are going to be sung.
Oh, yeah.
You know exactly what scripture's going to be read. You know exactly what time they're going to quit the service. They even let you bring pop in the sanctuary, Terry. And for 25 cents, you can bring a soft pretzel in. But I can tell you this, I would rather have the Word of God preached and in the Spirit of God leading us into freedom of what it is tonight. Because where the Spirit is, there's freedom. Amen. And the Bible says, the truth will set you free. I can tell you there's so many churches selling out. They're worried. We're just trying to preach without a heart. We're worried about things, Jay. But I can tell you this. If God is able to put some money in the mouth of a fish and Peter able to reel it in, he is able to keep the building of his house open.
Amen.
Then he can keep the lights on here.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
We might have a few weeds in the parking lot, but he can keep the lights out.
Amen.
Amen. The tension and the aggravated. What those sheep had back in that time was these little nasal flies. And they flew around the sheep, Kenny. And sheep can't flap at their face. Jake, their ears ain't even long enough to twitch at their nose. What those flies would do is they'd buzz around there, Terry. They'd lay those eggs on the wetness of their nose. And eventually those eggs would hatch out. They're like little worms. You know, you've seen them, just little fly larvae, maggots, whatever you want to call them. And they crawl up the nose of that sheep. So anytime the sheep wants to reach down to graze, it tricks its nose and it's aggravated. Jacob tries to get water, and it just has things in its face. I can tell you this. All that oil, when it gets on there, it has a way of taking things
Terry, that are aggravating you, the things that are festering in your life, you get God's Spirit, His oil on the problem. It has a way of protecting you. It has a way of soothing you. It has a way for you to say, thank you, Lord, you're my shepherd, and I shall not want. You've been out camping before, and you're sitting there, and you maybe have a little sore on your leg, Kenny, maybe one on your arm. Those old flies sit there and they hit that open spot. That's what Satan does, don't he?
Yeah.
He looks through our lives. He sees the weakest spot, Jay. He sees where we're sore at, Kenny. And that's where he gets us at. But I'm thankful the Word of God, the Spirit of God, it can put some oil around our lives. It can keep Satan at bay. I'm thankful tonight to know that God and Satan are on the same level. My God's bigger than Satan this morning.
Lord.
So many times we want to think the devil and God are on the same playing field. Church, have victory tonight. He is bigger than him.
Amen. That's right.
The Bible even says this: greater is he in me than he that's in the world. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I'm thankful, Terry. I have something in here that's even bigger than the devil. The Bible says this: submit yourself unto God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
Amen.
That's how we beat the devil.
Amen.
The Gospel says this: that at the name of Jesus, even the demons tremble. Jesus! Jesus! We can have hell trembling tonight by the name of Jesus! That's the power in my shepherd's name.
Amen.
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 So many times we act like we're whipped. So many times we act like we're defeated. But Jake, hell trembles when we cry Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. It says he restored my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Amen.
Yeah.
You ever needed the Lord to restore your soul?
Amen.
You know those little sheep? I can just picture a little fat, fluffy sheep full of wool. Just out there trotting around. Terry, sometimes they lose their footing.
Yeah.
And they roll over on their backs.
That's
they call them cast sheep. That's what they're called. When they're laying flat on their backs, Jake, and they can't roll over.
Right.
They sit there kicking. Sometimes they'll be, man, they'll get a little bleed out there. But they can't roll over. And the shepherd that loves the flock, then he stands up every few moments, Terry. And he gets a real good view of his flock. He starts counting, marking them off. And Jake, when he's got one less from what he started out with, he goes out, won't he? Jesus said that he'll leave the 99 and go for the one.
Amen.
He goes out there and he sees that little sheep over there laying on his back, and the shepherd rolls him over, John. He starts rubbing their body, starts rubbing their legs so the circulation comes back to them. Then he picks that little sheep up and carries it back to the flock.
Yeah.
He allows it to get its strength back.
Amen.
Before he puts it back on his feet.
Amen.
How many times has God restored my soul?
Amen.
Amen tonight.
Amen.
How many times I turned my back, found myself laying flat on my back, I'm kicking my legs and arms, and Jesus comes along and
amen.
He picks me up and he carries me and allows me to be
mine. Glory.
Wow, glory.
Amen. Bless the Lord.
Amen.
To revive.
Amen.
And he says, go on, little sheep. Let me put you back on the path of righteousness.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake.
Amen.
My little sheep, this is where you belong.
That's right.
My little sheep, follow me. Let me walk you down a path. Brother Terry, it might have valleys in it, but it's a path of righteousness.
Amen.
It's a path of peace.
Yeah.
If you're willing to follow.
Amen.
All you gotta do is walk after me, little sheep. There's a part in Scripture that Christ says, my sheep know me by my voice, and a stranger they will not follow.
Right.
Brother Terry, how many times we hear God's little voice beckoning us to come, and we turn it away tonight? You can be here tonight even to be restored. God's able to do that, amen. And I'm going to tell you this. Let's just break up some doctrine that don't make sense. Christ is not going to lead you down a path that's in contradiction to the Word of God. So many times churches, we say, oh, we're doing this for God. Shame on us, amen. If it goes against the Word of God, it's filthy. Let it go. If you can't find Jesus in that book, let it go, Kenny. Get back to where everything's about Jesus tonight.
Amen.
It says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me tonight. Kenny, I start thinking about them sheep and them being in the valley. The Bible says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. You know, the predators, Terry, they set up on top of a mountain and they scan that valley. They look for that weak little thing that they can run down and pounce on.
Yeah.
Oh, we're going to have valleys in our lives, church. Some may be deeper than others, but Terry, I can tell you this. If you follow the Lord, you're going to have a valley.
Amen.
But He's right there with you.
Amen.
He leads you through it.
Amen.
Now, there's no danger that can touch you when God's there protecting you. Amen.
Amen.
And I can tell you this. We all come with an expiration date. I know I'm saved by the grace of God, but this play that you see before you, Jay, it's going to be laid down to rest. And I'm thankful that when I walk through that valley of the shadow of death, there's going to be one that's with me. Amen. I can tell you this tonight. They sing that song, Going Away with a Friend. I'm thankful I know the one who's walking with me tonight. He's not a stranger, Scott. I don't have to wonder if he's going to be there. But I know him as my Savior, my King, my Lord, my God. And he's my friend. And he is with me tonight. Is he with you? Is he with you tonight? Amen. If he's not, he wants to be.
Amen.
He's the greatest friend I ever had, Jay. He's my personal greatest friend. But he can be yours too, amen. He'll make time for you too. And it says this. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Now understand that. We got to understand what them shepherd boys carried.
Yeah.
The rod was a little beater club, if I'm understanding it right, amen? And the staff, that's what you usually see at the nativity scenes. The little skinny, long pole with the hook on it. And that's what the staff. The rod the shepherd used for protecting the sheep. If an animal came in, Terry, they knew as young boys, they practiced throwing those rods. They could throw it with accuracy. They could knock the things out of the way. And they could also get those sheep's attention with the rod. If they had to throw it at the sheep to get their attention, they could. So his rod and staff comfort me. Jake, when I'm getting a whooping from God, it's comfort, amen. It may hurt at the time, Brother Terry, but it should comfort your soul, knowing that God loves you enough to hit you in the right direction. And his staff, it was used as a hook. He would hook those sheep right behind the back legs and he would turn it up so he could pull them, whether it be out of the water, whether it be out of the thorns. Aren't you glad your shepherd has a staff, Jake?
Amen.
Amen. Terry, I'm thankful that over 2,000 years ago, they marched my shepherd out on the hillside of Calvary.
Amen.
And they nailed him to an old rugged cross.
Amen.
That's been the greatest tool the shepherd used to grab every lost lamb, Jake, and to pull him directly to God and say, you are no longer of the world, but you're my child.
Amen.
And you're worthy to be called a child of God.
Amen.
And that little staff should bring us comfort. You know what's awesome about my shepherd, Terry? You know he doesn't drive me to do anything. He doesn't beat me on the head. But he leads.
Amen.
But the that small, still voice.
Amen.
He said, follow me. My little sheep, follow me. And I know his voice when it calls to me, Kenny. And it brings comfort to my heart. It gets me through another day. Jake, it gets me through another night when I lay down. And knowing that I have fellowship with the Lord. Amen. As thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies, I can tell you this, I've never seen sheep at a dinner table. Amen. Jake, have you? But I can tell you what this means tonight. I'm getting us some water here. We're almost done. Over there in the wintertime, when things would be dusted over, covered up, sometimes snow. Terry, the spring, the very first things that started to thaw out were the mountaintops. And over there where David's from, they have a lot of things that are called mesas, Jake. And they just pitched up on both sides and they're flat on top. So David's just relating that to a table. Mesa, in the Spanish language, means tables. What the shepherd would do is he knows the sheep are hungry. He would be the first one to go up there. Terry, he'd kick over the stones. He'd make sure the snakes weren't under there. He would go up there and pour some salt over the ground. Just to love that way they got their minerals as they're eating, amen. Terry, they'd also get up there. And they'd find the spots they was going to set up their camps. And they'd go down and get them sheep and take them up there. Even in the presence of my enemies, he prepares a table for me, Jake. And I can tell you this, he made that table acceptable and accessible to all.
Amen.
Through his son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you're here, you're hungry, you can pull right up to the table of God and you can eat manna directly from God's word.
Amen.
Amen. And it says, thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. We already talked about the oil. It's there to keep old Satan out of our lives. Our scars, the pain that's hurting us. Let God's Spirit pour over that. Let Him remove it out of your past, your present, your future. So you can go forth from tonight and say it's good to be revived.
Amen.
But Jake, He promises this. That our cup will run over. I don't care if you're sitting here with a teacup. Randy, if you brought a 5-gallon bucket, my God is big enough to fill each one tonight. Where they're overflowing and you can drink from the saucer tonight.
Amen.
Amen. That's the God I serve, Kenny. Whatever need I have today, He's able to meet it.
Amen.
He's able to feel it. Amen.
Amen.
It says this, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I got to talk about that a little bit at Evergreen Acres, didn't I? We should always have two friends with us. Goodness and mercy.
Amen.
Shall follow me all the days of my life. Amen.
Amen.
Kenny, anytime I look around, I should be able to see those two things following
Amen.
Me. Amen. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I can say that tonight because I can say the Lord is my shepherd.
Amen.
And if you cannot say the Lord is my shepherd, you will not dwell in His house.
That's right.
You better have that first figured out between you and God.
Amen.
And you can stand here saying, I'm a child of the King.
Amen.
And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'm going to say this and I'm going to shut up. I'm thankful it gets better than this.
Amen.
I got a wife and son back there who I love dearly.
Amen.
Brother Terry, we got just a little humble house out there on Palmer Road. And it's perfect for what we need.
Amen.
I got a family, like I said at the beginning, of uncles that take me hunting and fishing. A mom and dad who teach Sunday school. Jake, but it gets better than this.
Amen.
We're headed to a place.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Where all the pain we face down here ain't going to be able
that's right.
to mar the beauty that's up there.
Amen.
Amen.
I look out here. I see some of my family, a lot of my friends. And I don't know your name, I can still count you a friend in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
But we've all gone through some pain in our life.
Yeah,
we've all suffered some loss in our life. There's people waiting for me over there. Amen.
Amen.
It gets better than this down here.
Amen.
Just early in the week,
yeah.
We put Crystal's grandpa, Brother Terry, we said goodbye to him. Amen. But I'm thankful he's not lost. We know exactly where he's at tonight. He's in the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
And where they're at, Brother Scott, that's where I long to be. And that's where we're headed tonight, amen. It gets better than this. I want to leave you tonight with just a little bit of hope and encouragement. It gets better than this.
Amen.
The suffering we have down here is not going to compare to what's waiting for us over there. It gets better than this, church. But I'm thankful to be saved. Thankful to be a child of the King. Search your heart tonight. Whatever God's put on it to do, just do it tonight. Is it saying to get a song? All these other fellas can come. But it's good to be saved.
Amen.